Brethren, we're about to commence a four-day program. A program we are believing God will change the course of your life. A program that will destroy all those who have sworn that you will not progress. A program that will cause all those who will not repent to perish in the next 1 month. So I want you to talk to God. Every evil pursuer of my life, before the end of this program, you will perish in the name of Jesus. Can you begin to pray? Every evil pursuer of my life, before the end of this program, you will die in the name of Jesus. You are not praying. Every evil pursuer of my life, all those who have conspired and said I will not make it, those who plot daily for my downfall, those who say I will not progress, before the end of this week, the wrath of God will come upon them. Every arrow that they have sent against me, against every member of their family, I send it back to them in the name of Jesus. God has promised that he will contend with all who contend against you. This morning we pray, no weapon fashioned against us will prosper. Everyone who digs a pit for us, before the end of this week, that pit will bury them in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. You only just want to pray one prayer before we start the program. Say, Lord, intervene in my situation. I don't know what your situation is, but say, Lord, intervene in my situation. My enemies must not prevail over me. My enemies must not mock or laugh over me. Lord, prevail over my situation. Help me to prevail over my enemies. This week, oh Lord, give me victory over my adversaries. Everyone that is plotting against me, disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Disgrace them in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, the essence of this four-day program is prayers. We'll go into the word, but in less than 5-6 minutes we'll be through and then we'll pray. The Bible says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. The effectual fervent. All this implies violent prayer, serious prayer, prayer that does not take into consideration people around you. You pray as if you are alone with God. Violently you cry out. And for matters like this that we are going to deal with in the next 4 days, you must cry out. Can we bow down our heads in prayers? Father, Lord, we want to thank you. As we commence this four-day program, we ask, O God, that you will be with us because we are about to enter into warfare. All the enemies of our life, the enemies of our family, the enemies of our progress, we hand them over to you. Everything that they are planning, we return it back to them. Use this program, O God, to expose our enemies. Use this program to bring judgment upon them. Father, we thank you. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Please welcome somebody and say you are welcome to this program. Thank you very much. Psalm 41 verse 5. Are we there? Psalm 41 verse 5. Are we there? We are not there. Psalm 41. Are we there now? I'm surprised we are finding it difficult to open the Bible this morning. Psalm 41 verse 5. Are we there? I want to hear a more powerful yes than if you are there. Psalm 41 verse 5. My enemies speak evil of me. When shall he die? Tell yourself, I will not die. And his name perish. Tell yourself, my name will not perish. My enemies speak evil of me. When shall he die and his name perish? And if he come to see me, he speaketh vanity. His heart gathereth iniquity to himself. When he goeth abroad, he telleth it. All that hate me whisper together against me. Against me do they devise my heart. An evil disease, say they, cleave fast unto him. I reject it. And now that he lieth, he shall rise up no more. Impossible. Yes, my own familiar friend, in whom I trusted, we did eat of my bread, and lifted up his heel against me. But thou, O Lord, be merciful unto me, and raise me up, that I may requite them. By this I know that thou favorest me, because my enemy does not triumph over me. I speak to your life this morning. No matter the plans of the enemy, they will not triumph over you. No matter the plans that they make, they will not prevail over you. Brethren, there is no one that can say he has not got enemies. Only a foolish man will say that he has not got enemies. You don't need to offend people before they become your enemies. Some people are naturally wicked and they hate you, not because you have offended them, but because it's in their nature to hate. They plan against you not because you did anything against them, but because they take delight in planning evil. People wake up and find out that armed robbers have just raided them. What was their offense? Nothing. Some of those who armed robbers attack are even poorer than the armed robbers. A man is walking around not knowing that some people are looking for him for rituals. So don't say, I have no enemy. There are people who see you as an enemy. That you are alive is annoyance to them. That you are not sick is irritating to them. That you are coming to church angers them. So when the Bible keeps talking about war and warfare, you must understand that we live in perilous times. Living among very bad people. But among enemies, the most deadly is the enemy that is called a friend. The most deadly enemy is called a friend. Because a friend is somebody that has access to you. Is somebody that you trust. Is somebody that you believe is word. If he tells you, come to this forest, you will not doubt him. And so he has the capacity to do anything to you because you trust him. And in this scripture, all the evil that was being planned by a friend. Today, God will expose every unfriendly friend in your life in the name of Jesus. An enemy that you know is easier to deal with. But a friend who is an enemy is more difficult. You will leave your children with him, not knowing what he will do with them. He will lay hands on your head. He will make evil pronouncements. He will drop things in your house. But today, the judgment of God will come upon them. Every evil hand that has been laid upon your children will return to sender in the name of Jesus. You will see that in this scripture, enemies, they speak evil. When shall he die? When will his name perish? Every evil pronouncement that they made against you, we return them to sender in the name of Jesus. Every time they are plotting, trying to devise what will destroy you. But the Bible has said no weapon fashioned against you will prosper. So whatever it is they have devised, whatever plan that they have made, we return it to them in the name of Jesus. They begin to speak of diseases. Brethren, before any sickness comes upon you, somebody has spoken it. Sickness just don't come. Somebody called it. So they begin to call all kinds of strange sicknesses. Despite the fact that God has said, I will not allow the disease of Egypt to come upon you. Why was God specific about Egypt? Because God realized that the magicians in Egypt had the capacity to call on sickness. They can tell a man, you will die of stroke. And the next few days, the man will die of stroke. And so God protected his children. The disease of Egypt will not come upon you. So today, every sickness that has been pronounced against you, not only will it leave you now, it shall go back to its source in the name of Jesus. We are going to pray. And we are going to take certain prayer points. So please be ready to pray. Are we ready to pray? Please stand up. Please stand up. Tell your neighbor, I'm ready to pray. Tell your neighbor, I am ready to pray. We want to speak and pray according to God's word. And please, I want violent prayer. You can't be praying violently and remain in one position. A man who wants to be free cannot be stationary. He moves. You must move. When God created the heavens and the earth and he needed to change the darkness, he moved. He moved and then decreed.
So learn to move.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 8. He that diggeth a pit shall fall into it. And whoso breaketh an edge, a serpent shall bite him. Two prayer points here. Who is it that is digging a pit against my life? What is a pit? A pit is a trap. The essence of the trap is to destroy you, is to limit you, is to injure you, is to bring you lamentation, unhappiness. When you set a trap for an animal, you want to capture and kill it. So today we are going to pray. Everyone who has set a trap against me or my family, you will fall into that trap. Are we ready to pray? Are we ready to pray? My Father, my Father. My Father, my Father. Anyone. Anyone. Whether my friend or not my friend. Whether in my family or not in my family. Who has dug a pit for me? Who has dug a pit for my children? Fall into it. Fall into it. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I'm happy, I'm impressed. But please, I want to see you move. I want you to jump. I want you to clap. I want you to shout. You must arrest the attention of God. The second prayer point here is even more dangerous. Whoso breaketh an edge, a serpent shall bite him. Listen to me. A hedge is a protection. In spite of your protection, the enemy has gone to break the wall. You have surrounded yourself with prayers, with fasting, with holiness. Men of God have put an hedge around you. You believe you are secure because of the life you are living. But the enemy is unrelenting. I will still attack. And it begins to knock on your wall. And it breaks a part of it. But God is saying, he that breaks your edge, a serpent shall bite him. So you are going to pray this morning. My Father, my Father. My Father, my Father. Anyone. Who breaks into my life? Who breaks into my business? Who breaks into my joy? A serpent shall bite him. A serpent shall bite him. A serpent shall bite him. In Jesus' name, we pray.
In Proverbs 26:27, two prayer points, but we will take the second one because we have dealt with the first one. The first one says, whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein. We have dealt with that. But the second one says, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. There are people in the spirit who have rolled a stone against your picture. They have rolled a stone against your office. They have rolled a stone against your marriage. They have rolled a stone against your picture, your name, and everybody that is dear to you. And as they roll that stone in the spirit, they make a pronouncement. As long as this stone remains here, no progress can come into this family. But God is saying, he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. So we are going to pray, my father, whoever has rolled a stone against my happiness, against my joy, against my progress, that stone, crush him, crush him, crush him, crush him. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, this is a very serious prayer. And in this prayer, there will be no mercy. Esther chapter 7, verse 9. And Habona, one of the chamberlains, said before the king, behold also the gallows, 50 cubits high, which Haman had made for Mordecai, who has spoken good for the king, standeth in the house of Haman. Then the king said, hang him thereon. So they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai. Then was the king's wrath pacified. Brethren, those who want you to die will die immediately. Those who want you to die will die immediately. My father, my father! My father, my father! All those who are planning to kill me are members of my family. All those who are planning evil against us, today, die!
Amen. Amen.
If you have remained in one place, you are not praying. If you have remained in one place, you are not praying. Anyone who wants to excel in warfare must listen to instructions. Don't remain in one place. Move. You are not under captivity. Even the prayer of the mighty shall be delivered. You must move. Daniel chapter 3, verse 19. Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake and commanded that they should heat the furnace 17 times more than it was wont to be heated. And he commanded the most mighty men that were in his army to burn Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their coats, their hosting, and their hats, and their other garments, and were cast into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Therefore, because the king's commandment was urgent, and the furnace exceedingly hot, the flame of the fire slew those men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You don't understand what I just read. You are going to pray. All those who have finalized plans, the fire, trouble will come to you. Today, the fire of God will roast them. The fire of God will roast them. My Father, all those who have conspired to come together to burn me with fire, problems, trouble, I command fire to roast them. Fire, fire, roast them. Roast them. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. There are many other prayer points, but we'll reserve them. But we'll just take these two, and then we'll close for today, because 7:30 we must close. Luke 21, verse 12. But before all this, they shall lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and into prison, being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake, in verse 13, and he shall turn to you for the testimony. He shall turn to you for the testimony. You are going to pray. My Father, every evil plan of the enemy against my life, against my family, against my business, he shall talk to me for the testimony. He shall talk to me for the testimony. He shall talk to me for the testimony. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. One example. But sometimes the enemy thinks they want to destroy us. But God will turn their destruction to our own good. If the devil had known that crucifying Jesus on the cross of Calvary will give Jesus the key of death, of hell, they would not have tried it. If they had known it would resurrect, they would not have tried it. In 2 Samuel chapter 6 verse 9, and David was afraid of the Lord that day and said, how shall the ark of the Lord come to me? So David would not remove the ark of the Lord unto him into the city of David. But David carried it aside into the house of Obededom the Gittite. And the ark of the Lord. Amen. David was bringing the ark of God to the city of Jerusalem. And somebody touched it and the person died. Ah, David said, this is terrible. I cannot carry death to my house. If this thing can kill somebody for touching it, I will not carry it. Where will I carry it to? And somebody said, Obededom is a useless person. Go and drop it in his house. If he kills him, nobody will miss him. He said, it's true. I better go and drop it in Obededom's house. If he kills him, let him kill him there. We are not carrying it again. So they carried it and they dumped it in Obededom's house. But what happened? And the ark of the Lord continued in the house of Obededom the Gittite 3 months. And in those 3 months, the Lord blessed Obededom and his house. You are going to pray, my father, my father. Every plan of the enemy shall turn to my blessing. Every plan of the enemy shall become my promotion. Every plan of the enemy shall bring me favor. Pray! Amen. Amen. Father, Lord, we want to thank you for day one of this program. Thank you, O God, for your mercy. Thank you, O God, for your love for us. Thank you for the assurance that no matter the plan of the enemy, they will not prevail over us. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that acts as a covering over our lives. Today, Lord, we have prayed. Every arrow that the enemy has sent, we return them in the name of Jesus. Every pit that they have dug, let it bury them in the name of Jesus. Every fire that they have lit, let it roast them in the name of Jesus. Every debt that they have planted, let it kill them in the name of Jesus. We decree this in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please, tomorrow will be greater. Wednesday will be greater. And Thursday will be greatest. Thank you for coming. God bless you. The grace.